Well, tonight, investigators are still trying to piece together what caused a Dundalk woman to drive onto the Beltway in the wrong direction. Her vehicle crashed head-on into an SUV, killing herself and a 3-year-old child in the other car. 11 News I-10 reporter Barry Sims is live outside of the MDTA police headquarters with an update on the investigation. Barry?
Well, Stan, the injured in this case are a mother and child. 29-year-old Kimberly Taylor was one of the drivers, and she underwent surgery today. She is in serious condition at shock trauma. Her 2.5-month-old daughter, Mackenzie Kelly, is in stable condition at Johns Hopkins and is expected to be released pretty soon. Again, the big question is, why did the other driver go the wrong way?
It was a very serious crash scene, for sure.
Maryland Transportation Authority police are investigating a double fatal accident. It happened just after 10 Sunday night on the I-695 outer loop at the Curtis Creek drawbridge.
There was significant damage to both vehicles. Both vehicles were moving at highway speeds. And this caused significant damage to both vehicles. Both vehicles required extrication by fire and EMS personnel, rescue personnel, to get the parties out of the vehicles.
Investigators say 21-year-old Victoria Lynn D'Angelo of Dundalk was going in the wrong direction on the outer loop when her car hit head-on with an SUV. D'Angelo was killed. A 3-year-old passenger in the SUV, Lily Kelly, also died. Her mother, 29-year-old Kimberly Taylor of White Marsh, is listed in serious condition at shock trauma. Taylor's other child, 2.5-month-old Mackenzie Kelly, is in stable condition at Johns Hopkins Medical Center. Investigators believe D'Angelo entered the highway at an exit ramp going in the wrong direction.
We believe that she got on at the exit 1 exit to Quarantine Road northbound, but in the opposite manner. She, in essence, got on an exit ramp.
MDTA Police Sergeant Jonathan Green says there is no clear indication alcohol was involved. That remains under investigation. He was asked if construction on Quarantine Road may have caused confusion.
There is an ongoing project in the Quarantine Road overpass area, but this project has been going on for some time, and a great deal of effort has been made to maintain the signage for the area.
MDTA police tell us that it may take weeks for them to finish their investigation. Reporting live from Dundalk, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Barry.